intersection of being of mixed ethnicity and female. And then what happens when, I guess, white male desire slash objectification turns a little bit racist. For me and my sisters and nieces, it was, you know, from a fairly young age, it's always been kind of embarrassing and a bit shaming and a bit confusing. Perhaps ever since I was about 12 and someone, a boy whispered in my ear, "You look really so pretty for a brown girl."
Oh.
So I also wrote this, not about that, but from like a male point of view, in the interest of maybe learning something new. But probably just about how I see it, really. And it's it's called Streetlight Marmalady. Hey sister, go sister, soul sister, go sister. Hey sister, soul sister, go. Jo never expected to meet anyone like her, but here she is, marmalade skin, shining among the rough, cutting up pavements, strutting her stuff in broad daylight through town. He got itchy eyes and twitchy way down just watching her. She was bitchy, he could tell. She was smiling hot as hell. Itchy, gitchy, ay, 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 ay. Joe was white as snow, not a virgin though. Just a keeps his hands clean shade of pale. He drank ale and worked real hard until he slipped. So now he votes Brexit and drinks bitter. Sometimes he has to delete things he said at 3 a.m. on Twitter. Who doesn't? He's got form on the Northern Soul Circuit, but in another life he'd have been a disco kid in flares, Boogie Nights and Patti LaBelle. But who cares and what the hell? When the boys come raging through town with St. George flags like drunk bulls with red rags, that's the only scene. Still, he keeps his hands clean. Of course, sometimes he sins. But Joe's a man who hopes for better things. And so when she said, "Hey Joe, wanna give it a go?" Snow White Joe turned around real slow and nearly said no, but oh, mocha chocolate, yeah, yeah. Where was she from? A face that launched itself into his. Caramel lushness, fuchsia lipsticked beauty. She says, "Well, wouldn't you like to know, Joe? I might be from just down your road." Ha, says Joe, "not lightly. There's no one around here like you. Those girls are all slappers and tarts." And she throws back her head and laughs. Looks like he's in with the chomps. The light changes and seems her flesh does too. Silhouetted in the sun, she flushed a darker hue. Now, under streetlight, she's almost not quite white again. A betting man might see winnings. Joe just hopes for better things. He holds her hand under the table in Maryland's chicken shop. Fingers find a thigh. She gives a sigh that doesn't say stop. And from the corner of his eye, he sees them coming. Door slams shut behind loud and boozy swaggering. It's like a dagger in the gut to see these mutts. They swivel eyes, recognize him. "Whoa, Joe, what you got there, mate?" Too late, he's up. Beer is spilled, totally killed the moment. Next, he's getting vexed, although it's what's to be expected. Itchy, glitchy moments, feeling like a donut pass. "What, me? With her? Are you having a laugh? What, her? With avec moi? Well, she's got a nice ass. Joe does what he needs to do, what any man would. And she should have understood. Not dumped her Diet Coke all over his grey flannel suit. This ain't no joke. He's angry now, the city county is telling. She needs taken by the elbow. So what if tears are welling up? This disrespect needs quelling. They're all watching how he'll manage. This beast's gone savage. So fuck off, black bitch," he says. Maryland Chicken Shop needed a good mop. And she was never so glad to be shown the door. Now, back under streetlight, it's hard to be sure what she went in there for. Voulez-vous coucher avec moi ce soir? Although she did look back once more, again, hoping to see Joe in a mess of rowdy men. But among the white shirts, he was just another bloke, staying with beer and Diet Coke.